He saw his children doing evil. He could have spoken and hit them by the rod. Eli did not do so. That was just the only problem of Eli. In trying to follow the footsteps of Jesus, let it not be with hypocrisy. Listening to the voice of the Holy Spirit. But another thing again is that God will have to help us and train us to understand how do we listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. But that's going to be another subject. How did Jesus listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit? How did Jesus know what the Holy Spirit wanted him to do? Let me just give you one tip of that, because that's going to be another subject. Study your Bible. The Holy Spirit will not bring to your heart what you have not put in. Okay, all of us have a computer, right? Do you tell your computer to do something you did not put inside of it? Just like the application I'm using right now. I don't know, is Jesus going to use an application? So every time I'm always asking myself a question, is Jesus going to sit down or is Jesus going to stand up when preaching? So if you continue like this, every area of your life, you'll be asking yourself, what would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? And then he can overtake your inner man. And then somebody might look at you and say, is something wrong with you? You should know what to do here. But you should not. Like, if I'm driving by the road, is Jesus going to put his seat belt? Yes, he's going to put his seat belt, because he doesn't want to obey. He doesn't want to disobey the laws of the land. It's always good to always ask yourself, what's the footstep of Jesus? If Jesus had a wife and he was having a problem with his wife, okay, is Jesus going to wait for the husband to say, I'm sorry? No, Jesus will go to the husband and say, I'm sorry, please forgive me. And Jesus will even kneel down. Now it's hard. But this is where God needs to break our ego. This is where God needs to break, you know, every self in our inward man, you know. So when Jesus with the money changers, he was only doing what the Holy Spirit wanted him to do at that moment. You know why? Because there are people that will condemn you for doing or for following the footstep of Jesus. Don't mind them. Just do what you know is right to do. Basically, for me, I don't know, it might not be the ministry of other people, but for me, I will not see any evil doctrine on this earth without me speaking. I will speak, because the Bible says, expose every unfruitful work of darkness. Will Jesus do so? Yes, he will do so. Yes, he will do so. Jesus will not keep silent in the face of evil. I pray that God will help us to follow this footstep. My brothers and sisters, if we continue like this, we realize that this is the kind of life Jesus lived for 33 years. Before I came here, somebody called me. And then, now, I was already coming here. The person was like, maybe something's happening to somebody and the person is in big problem. I need to pray a deliverance prayer. You know, see, but I don't want to pray because I know how to pray. I don't want to, professor. I told the person, get back to me later. The person said, no, sir, pray.